.NET Conf. Do you want to introduce yourself and then take it away?
Yep. Hello, can you see my screen?
Yep, we can see you perfectly.
Hello, hello.
Yep, all good.
Okay, let's get started. Hello, friend. Welcome to the .NET Conference 2018. My name is Thien. I'm from Vietnam. And I am the maintainer of the SimplCommerce. As some of you may know, SimplCommerce is an open source cross platform modular e-commerce built on the .NET Core. Today, I will talk about modular architecture with ASP.NET Core. English is not my first language, so I'm sorry if I don't pronounce correctly. Okay, thank you. This is a slide about myself, but I think you can check out it later if you interest. This is the agenda of my talk. First, I will briefly introduce about modular architecture. Then I will talk about how we apply modular architecture in SimpleCommerce. And finally, I will show you some early work from the .NET team that can help us to apply the modular architecture easier. So this is the picture of modular architecture. In the modular architecture, the application is divided into many modules. For example, in the case of an e-commerce application, we can have customer module, product module, order module, payment, shipping, and etc. Normally, one module is one project in Visual Studio that can be developed separately. Then eventually, all the modules will be deployed into a single web host. And normally, we usually have only one database for an entire application. It is different a bit to compare with microservices architecture. In microservices architecture, every service is deployed into their own host. And in microservices, normally there are many databases. Per my observation, a module can be added or removed in two ways. First, it adds the development time. That means if we want to add a module to the application, we have to add reference to it, then rebuild and redeploy the application. The second approach is to be able to add the module at the runtime. That means in somewhere in the application, we will have a UI for the user to find, to download, to install or uninstall a module directly on the fly without rebuild or redeploy the application. Some kind like WordPress. I know many of us know WordPress. And it is very convenient for the user, but it is very hard for developer to enable this in our ASP.NET Core application. And I will tell you why along the presentation. So what is the benefit of being modular? There are a lot of benefits of being modular. Here are some. First, separation of concern. Every module only care about one particular problem in the app. For example, the product module only care about product, and the order module only care about order. Second, it is easier to add, remove, or modify a module without affecting to the rest of the application. And in some situation, the user can choose which module they want to add into the application. And if they don't want to use some particular module, they can remove it. For example, in some customer, they only want to have a website to show their product, but they don't sell them. In that case, they can use only the product module and they can remove all the other module like order, shipping, payment, and so on. Third, a module can be easily developed in parallel. This is extremely important for the big project that's developed by different teams. And finally, a well modular architecture can help our code easier to read and easier to maintain. Although there are many benefits of being modular, however, there are also some challenges. The biggest challenge, I think, is they no native support. I could not find any document or guideline from Microsoft about how to apply in modular architecture for the ABNet Core application. And I had to do a lot of work around to be able to apply this architecture for SimplCommerce. And sometimes it is hard to separate modules properly. Sometimes we don't know which module to put the code into. Things are not black and white. I'm sorry. Things are not always black and white. And to be able to separate modules properly, we had to understand deeply about the domain knowledge. And finally, when we have a lot of modules, it is hard to manage the dependency. There are two kinds of dependency. The first is dependency between the module. For example, a module order must depend on the module product. We cannot order without a product, right? This is only the one-way dependency. The order depends on the product, but the product cannot depend on the order. And the second type of dependency is the dependency of the library, because a module can be developed by a different team, and maybe there are some cases a multiple version of one library is used. For example, the product module utilize auto mapper version 7, and the shipping module use auto mapper version 6. For example. Okay, now let's talk a bit about SimpleCommerce. I'm going to open our repository in the GitHub. SimpleCommerce is a cross-platform modular e-commerce system built on the .NET Core. I have started to build this project in January 2016, that means more than 2 years from now. At the beginning, it's just like a sample project for me to practice the ABNet Core. But after receiving a very good reaction from the community, you see, we have a lot of stars. And then I got motivated. Then after a lot of sleepless night and a lot of weekend, now SimplCommerce is a big project that has a lot of modules. Currently, we have around 30 modules for entire the app. We have order, we have inventory, we have shipping, we have payment, and many more. This is the home page of the project. SimplCommerce can run on any platform. It can run on Docker, on Windows, in Linux or Mac. And we have tested it on SQL Server, Postgre, MySQL or SQLite. And it's free and open source. Here we can take a look of online demo of the application. Yeah, this is a new team I had just built like some weeks ago. We can like, for example, we can go to the product detail. We can support the product can have like many variation, like the color and the size, many size. And we had the rating and the review also. Okay, now let's go through the code. I will show you how we apply modular architecture in SimplCommerce. Now here I have a Visual Studio open, and this is the SimplCommerce solution. There are 34, there are 42 projects, and I will, this is the infrastructure. The infrastructure here like some utility or helper. And this DOM logic. And this is the web host. The web host is an ab.net application. It is by a shell to lot and time module up the application. Every module will contain all the material for the module to be able to run. It has like the model, the domain model. This domain model will be mapped to the database. And it has controller, it has view component. And in SimplCommerce, we use like generic database. But sometimes we need some methods beyond the generic repository. We can implement the custom repository here. And we can have the services to do some business logic and also the view. On the static content like CSS and JavaScript also are put into a module also. The other module are similar. And now we have a lot of module. How the MVC know and lost our module in the application? So let's take a look up the, I'm sorry, I have missed one important thing. In the module, there is one file called module.json. And this is the file we can put the metadata for our module. For example, the name of the module, the version of the module, and they want interesting property we call a bundle with the host. Its value can be true or false. If its value is set to true, that means this module is bundled with the host. That means we cannot like unturn them. This feature is added recently to enable the faster startup and the smaller deployment footprint. The concept is some kind of similar to AB.NET to the AB.NET meta packet like Microsoft AB.NET.app or Microsoft.abnetcore.on. And if we set this property to true, we had to add referendum in the web host. If we set the value false, and then we don't need to referendum in the web host. Okay, then actually on the module we will copy into the web host. In the web host, there are also a folder called module, and we have many on the module also can be found here. But it is the deployable version of the module. It contains no C# code. It just contains the maybe some binary or the view and maybe other stuff for the application to run. And the static content is copied into the www root of the host. For example, you can see there we had the CMS module, we had the www root, and the on the content of the www root here will be copied to the www root of the host module and CMS here. The copying process is done by using a custom MS build task. Here, as you can see, we do some custom event after the target build. That means after the build event of the web host, we call a group command to copy entire module to the web host. Let's take a look at the web host. Sorry, let's take a look at the group file. Here, the group file is quite simple. Here, we can define some variable, and then we will load and type the module. Here, we will look for the module.json. And then the copy module. The copy module we call the copy static. In the copy static, we will copy on the view the module.json and maybe some other stuff. Here, you can see that if the module is not bundled with the host, we need to copy the build output of that module. So later on, if we want to like remove a module, we can only delete the folder of the module. Okay, now on the content on the module are copied to the web host. And now when the application start up, how the AB.NET Core loads our module. So let's take a look at the startup.cs. Here in the configure service, we can load internal module. let's drill down to the implementation of that method. In that method, we will first look for the module folder in the web host. Then we will look through and type the module in that folder. If the bin folder exists, that means the module is not bundled with the host. We had to load them manually. So let's drill down to the load module method. Here we will look through on the assembly of that module and use assembly load context to load them. Sometimes an assembly may be loaded in previous module. In that case, an exception will be true, and we catch it exception, and we get back the loaded assembly. And here we also compare the version. For example, if the auto mapper version A has been loaded, now we want to to load the another version of AutoMapper, it will rule an exception. Then we will look for the main assembly of the module. In the module, maybe there in the bin directory of a module, maybe there are many assembly. So we can take a look at here in the bin, and here. In this is on the assembly in the CMS module, we can see there are many assembly. Then we had to look for the main assembly of the module. That means SimplCommerce.module.cms. This is the main assembly. After that, we can have on the assembly of the module loaded. But MVC doesn't know about them. So we had to register our assembly with the application pack. This is the one of the cool feature of the ASP.NET Core to support the like this kind of application. Here we will look through the main assembly. The module and register them with the application pack. Okay, next how the MVC can find our view, because our view is not in the view folder. As you can see, the our view of our module is sitting here, not in the view as normally. So, to able to let the MVC know to how to find the view, we had to implement a custom view expander location. So I can show you the code here. We call module view location expander. That's implement and the interface of view location expander. And in this method, we will look for the controller that is serving the request. Then we will look for the module that contains that controller. Then here we will guide the view engine to find the view for that module. Here are some other logic to enable the dynamic theming. Then how about the dependency injection? In SimplCommerce, we use AutoFact to register on the assembly of the module. Let's see the code here. Yeah. After we had on the main assembly of on entire module, we will look through those assembly and we will register on the tie begin with on the tie end with repository service provider and handler. But in many cases, a module needs to register a dependency by itself. And here we also support that scenario. So let's take a look at for example, that module. In a module, we can create a class that implements the interface called iModule initializer. There is two methods in that interface, configure and configure service. Those two methods is very like the configure and the configure service in the application startup. And let's take a look at the here. In the configure service in the startup file of the host, we will find out on the implementation of the interface iModule initializer, and we call configure service to register the dependency of a module. And similarly, in the configure service, we also call the configure methods for a module. Okay, then how about the database? How about we, in SimplCommerce, we use entity framework core, and how we customize, let's say what we did to enable entity framework core to support the modular architecture. So per my observation, there are two approaches to enable the to make it happen in the modular architecture application like this. The first is one TV context for a module. Every module will maintain their own TV context. This approach is slightly very complicated, because when the application has many DB context and it's hard to manage them. The second approach is one DB context for entire application. And in SimplCommerce, we would like to keep things as simple as possible. So we have chosen the one DB context for entire application. So let's take a look at the DB context. Here, the simple DB context. And on the model, let's take a look at on model creating methods. Here, we will get on the type of every module, and we add to a list called tie to register. And after that, we call the register entity, where we will find on the class that inherits from the entity pay. And we register them with the simple DB context. And after that, we also make some customized customization on the convention to make our database look modular. We have implement a convention for the table name. So let's take a look at the database. So it is the database of SimplCommerce. So as you can see here, the table name will have the prefix is the module name. For example, the menu table of the module CMS will have CMS underscore menu. We have catalog, we have CMS, we have core, we have order, and so on. There are around 80 table in SimplCommerce. But sometimes convention is not enough. And in many scenarios, we would like to do some custom mapping for our entity. In that case, we can create a class that implement the interface I custom modifier, and in the build method, we can map we can write our custom mapping here. For example, here I want to map the name of the ASP.NET entity table. So we had call run, and here we can do like some relationship, and the sys data also be implemented here how we sys the data for our application. Okay, this is almost on the thing on how we apply modular architecture in SimplCommerce. Let's get back to the slide. Here we have done the demo. And I see there are some limitation of the modular architecture in SimplCommerce currently. The first limitation is adding or removing module will require the website to be restart. Currently, it is also the limitation of .NET Core. In .NET Core, there is no way to unlock an assembly. And the second limitation I can see is currently we haven't support the side-by-side dependency. For example, one module you auto mapper version 7, and the other module you the auto mapper version 6. When both two modules is bundle together, they will throw an exception. But I see the problem, maybe we can resolve it in the future. Observation, I see a very good prototype from Nice Mixmaster. So we can see his blog post here. In this blog post, he has made some prototype and explained how we lost the plugin. And here we utilize many assembly logic content. In SimplCommerce, we use only one default assembly log content for all the module. But in nice approach, he use each assembly log content for a module. That means he has many assembly log content in the application. And with this approach, he can support like side-by-side dependency. And the other good news is that recently there is a pull request that enable unloading and up an assembly content not being merged to the .NET Core COR repo. And so maybe we can unload the assembly in the future soon. So this pull request had been merged 22 days ago. Okay, there are some little time I would like to show you about the teaming in SimpleCommerce. For example, it is one team. And here we can there are some problem with the certificates. I don't know why. This is the administration where we can manage manage our e-commerce website. Here in the team, we can choose like another team. Here we can like this team is currently used, and we can change to another team, and maybe we can also download the team. So I want to apply this, and if we want to go to the home page, so yeah, you can see the team is changed. And we don't need to rebuild or to redeploy the application. It just happened on the fly. And it's very easy to build a new team for SimpleCommerce. To build a new team for SimpleCommerce, all we need is to create a folder in the team, folder of the host. For example, in this solution, we have two teams. And in this folder, we have the team.json where we put on the metadata for our team. And then we normally we will override the layout for our team. Yeah, we can use each team has their own layout. In this layout, we can reference to the different set of the JavaScript or different CSS, different style sheet. And if you want to, sometimes we also would like to modify like the structure of the HTML. In that case, we can override the view. So we can create a view, and the location of the view has to be the same as the location of the original view. We normally will based on the structure of the view here, and we will create another view in that location. And if the view engine found the custom view here, it will automatically override the original view. And here, in the the developer root. They also contain a folder called team, and then we have the team name, and we can put the static content for our team here. And that's all we need to do the custom team for SimplCommerce. And this also on the content I would like to share with you today. And now I'm happy to answer the question that you may have. Thank you. Do we have any question?
He's been saying that you're doing a great job. So for the platform, how long ago did you start in working on it?
I have been working on it for more than 2 years.
More than 2 years? What made you start with it?
Yeah. Sorry?
What made you start the platform, the project?
Actually, 2 years ago, when I want to study about .NET Core, ASP.NET Core, and I want to practice my skill, and then I create this project for practicing. But after that, I got a very good reaction from the community, and then I got motivated. And then I develop it until now.
No, that's great. Hey, I was going to say that I have a question in here from Ancient Coder. He's asking, that platform looks amazing. Is it open source?
Yes, it's completely open source and free also.
So show me how would I go about getting it in case Ancient Coder missed it and other people are joining the channel.
Okay, you can look at the repository in the GitHub. Yeah, it's you can find github.com/simplecommerce. And this is the Apache license. That means completely open source and free on show. On the course and on the implementation on the working is doing here.
Wow, that's amazing. So what kind of help do you need for this? Because obviously I know you probably have a job, you know, you're busy, you probably have family. So what kind of stuff would you like people to help you with in this open source project, which by the looks of it, everybody's saying, oh, wow, this is hard. You know, Ancient Coder said, wow, that's great. Thanks so much for sharing your hard work with the community. So how can people help you?
Yeah, it's very easy. You can take a look at this project and you can suggest the feature. You can help to find out the bug. You can help us fixing the bug or implement new feature. Yeah, we have a lot of work need to be done here, and you can pick one of them to do and then submit the pull request.
So everybody out there in the Twitter channel, hey, if you guys have any spare time, you know, help Thien out with SimplCommerce. From your looks, you know, from based on the comments, everybody's loving it. It's a great platform. Thien, thank you so much for contributing your time and your efforts to the community. It is projects like these that make the .NET community to be an awesome place to be and work with. All right. I don't think we have any more questions.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. And I will talk to you later.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone.